All right. So now let's look at point defects. So if you see this crystal lattice, so these are the atoms or lattice side there where there are atoms, and you see that in this position there is no atom where it has, where it should have been, right? Such a defect is called vacancy. And here you see that there should be an atom of this type, but some other foreign atom which is larger than this one is actually coming and sitting, is actually substituting for the position of the parent atom, right? It is actually substituting the parent atom, and hence it is called substitutional impurity, substitutional point defect. It is actually substituting for the position. And here if you see, this is actually not a lattice site, but this atom actually comes and sits in the interstitial positions available amongst the lattice sites, and hence such a defect is called interstitial point defect. Okay, and now if you carefully look at it, look here, you have a vacancy, and very close to that vacancy you have an interstitial, right? You have a vacancy here, and very close to the vacancy you have an interstitial, and such a pair is called Frankel pair. It's a one particular kind of a defect. So that means you are having a vacancy, but very close to that vacancy there is an interstitial. That means it is probably this, the atom which should have been sitting here is actually did not go there, and it is hanging around there. So these two, if this guy goes there, it would have become a perfect crystal. And such a pair of defects, point defects, are called Frankel pair. Is that clear? Okay. So this is a gallium arsenide system. This here, that what we see is a gallium arsenide system. So the black dots are gallium, and this is arsenic, right? And then in that you have impurities of boron and indium, right? So you have, because the size of indium is larger than all other atoms, usually it forms a substitutional point defect, because the interstitial sites will not be having enough space for this boron to go and sit in the interstitial sites, and the interstitial sites are usually occupied by the impurity atoms which are smaller in size compared to the parent atoms. So the boron, for instance, if you see here, sometimes it can actually substitute, but there is higher probability for this boron to go and sit near the interstitials because there is free space available. It doesn't have to knock off the existing parent atom. Okay. So even even when you are looking at point defects, you have different kinds of point defects, right? Depending upon the size of the atoms and so on. Okay. So this is, for instance, this is NaCl structure. This is the perfect guy, defect free. And here you have a Frankel defect. Frankel defect means an interstitial and a vacancy side by side. If you have a vacancy here and you don't have an interstitial here but from far away, then those two cannot be called as Frankel pair, because they should be close to each other. And there is another kind of defect which is called Schottky defect. What is a Schottky defect? Schottky defect is a pair of vacancies that have opposite signs. That means you have both elements, Na, sodium and chlorine. One is positively charged and one is negatively charged. And you need to have vacancies of these two guys together. So here what should have been there? Sodium should have been there. Here chlorine should have been there. Both of them are missing. So you have a pair of vacancies which are of opposite side. One is a anion and another is a cation. They are not present in the crystal lattice. And such a pair is called Schottky. Okay? Schottky defect. So these two kinds of defects are usually found in compounds, ceramic compounds, right? Ceramics and intermetallics, right? So it's very important to understand these two kinds of defects and their role in the mechanical behavior of these ceramics. Okay. So how can you create point defects? Is it possible to create point defects? Yes, they can actually be created by thermal activation. That means if you heat, you increase the temperature of a material, then you create, what will you do? By increasing the temperature, you are providing energy to your atoms, and then if you provide sufficient energy, the atoms can actually jump out of their equilibrium position and then move around, right? So creation of point defect. So when you create a point defect, what happens? The internal energy of the system or the crystal increases. So if the creation of point defects increases the internal energy of the crystal, why does nature create point defects in first place? Because what does nature try to do? For every system, it will try to minimize the energy. But by creation of a point defect, you are going to increase the internal energy of the system, because you are actually creating the local distortion, and that will create the increase the internal energy of the system. You are increasing the internal energy. So if that is the case, ideally you should not be, your system, so nature should not be actually creating point defects, but you have point defects in the material. So what is the reason for that? Right? That is the question that we are trying to address now.